Éiste, Bennachtta Láí le Páidhachtaíomh go léir, agus cuirm fáilte Críol Róimh, cibáit ar dhonn a bhfuil sibh an tráthnóna seo. On behalf of the Irish Embassy in the Longway, welcome to everybody, and I wish you a happy St. Patrick's Day wherever you have joined us from this evening. This is a very special occasion for me and for my wife Mary, as we mark our first St. Patrick's Day since we arrived in Malawi just over 2 months ago. Unfortunately, we are unable to have our traditional St. Patrick's Day reception, but we hope that you will enjoy the virtual program we have put together, one that we hope reflects the warm relationship between Ireland and Malawi. We extend a warm welcome to all of the Irish community and Friends of Ireland in Malawi, to those of you who have spent time here in the warm heart of Africa and are watching from afar. We also welcome representatives of our many partners in Malawi, government, civil society, NGOs, trade and cultural organisations, and indeed members just across, people across all of Malawi who are watching this. And a special greeting to the Malawi community in Ireland, who I know are looking in this evening. We hope that the links between our countries will continue to grow and deepen in the coming years, and especially across areas of trade, commerce and investment. And I know that many of you here this evening who are participating will have a special interest in this. While the past year has been difficult, we've continued to deepen our relationship with Malawi and with the government of President Lazarus Chakwera. And we wish the president and his government well in the years ahead. 2020 was an important year for Malawi and for its citizens, particularly in regard to the important statement that citizens made about the importance of democracy and governance and the importance of free and fair elections. We hope that the country will benefit from the decisions taken in 2020 in the years ahead. Looking to the future, Ireland will continue to support important initiatives aimed at poverty reduction, mitigating the impact of climate change, promoting women's rights, and helping to build strong institutions that support good governance. We will do this through our annual 15 million development programme and our regular dialogue with government, civil society and multilateral organisations. Our membership of the European Union and our strong support for European values is important to us in this regard. And as a strong supporter of European ideals and values, we will continue to work closely with the EU across a range of issues. Ireland's relationship with Malawi is important to us, and we will work to strengthen this. This includes working on together in the cultural area, and this is the main theme of this evening's virtual reception. Very soon, you will see Irish and Malawi artists joining together in song and music, reflecting the deep traditions of music and storytelling that is such an important part of both of our cultures. Thank you for joining us, and I hope that you enjoy this year's virtual reception. And we hope that next year we will all be together in person, but in the meantime, we hope you enjoy the rest of today, which is a very special day for Irish people all over the world. Slán is Bwin Soltas an Sprí. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to listen to a special St. Patrick's Day message from an Taoiseach, Mr. Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Ambassador. And I would like to wish you and everyone in Malawi a very happy St. Patrick's Day. A Cárta Gael is a Cárta Galéir. Lá speisialta é lá éile pádraig. De gach Gael sa bhaile nu har lár. St. Patrick's Day is a special day. A day when no matter where in the world we are, we celebrate our heritage and culture. So let me begin by wishing you all a happy St. Patrick's Day to our 70 million strong diaspora and our many friends across the globe. This has been a difficult year for our Irish community abroad. Many of you have lost loved ones. You have been unable to spend time with family and friends. You have missed Christmas, birthdays, weddings, and sadly, even funerals. I want in particular to acknowledge and thank the many Irish who have helped lead the fight against COVID-19, our dedicated health workers at home, but also the many Irish doctors and nurses, research scientists and public health officials around the world. Many of you have put yourselves and your families at risk so that others might be safe. But now, at last, we can look forward to better days. St. Patrick's Day is our day, but that doesn't mean it is only for us. St. Patrick's Day is an open-hearted invitation to a global expression of community. It's a day that gives us a unique opportunity to speak to the world about who we are and how we can contribute to the well-being of humanity. There is, I believe, an ambition that we all now share, that we will learn from what has happened, and that our responses will reflect both our interconnectedness and our interdependence. Just as the pandemic has brought out the best in us, we can use the same instincts to shape the future, bringing new meaning and values to our lives and to our role in the world. We are Irish, but we are also global citizens. COVID-19 has reminded us that we need global solutions and international cooperation for global challenges, that no nation, large or small, can meet these challenges on their own. St. Patrick's Day is an opportunity for us, this year especially, to express that sense of solidarity. Ireland is an open country, an outward-facing place. Irish people have always sought to make a contribution wherever they have gone. The same wish to serve inspires us now. We will work with partners around the world to overcome the dreadful pandemic and to support economic and social recovery. In doing so, we will work to make sure that nobody, especially the poorest parts of the world, gets left behind. We've taken up a seat on the UN Security Council for the next 2 years, and we will use that position to work for peace and security throughout the world to the very best of our ability. We will continue to reach out a hand of friendship and hopefully, when we can, to welcome people back to Ireland, including those of you that have been unable to visit in recent times. As Irish people down the ages have done, we will try to make a difference every day, no more so than here on our island. As we approach the centenary of the foundation of our state, building on the achievement of the Good Friday Agreement, we will work through our Shared Island Initiative to underpin peace and to advance the cause of reconciliation, shaping a better future for all the people. Our history, our culture, our values, and our experience place us in a position to do great good in the world. There is an Irish saying, Isar ská a chéile a bharan na daoine. We live in each other's shadow. It speaks to our sense of interdependence, of community and solidarity. Let that be our message on this special day for the global Irish. And so to conclude, we are thinking of you all today as you celebrate throughout the world. We are looking forward to welcoming you all home soon. Until then, berbua, benacht, agus gurib míle mahaguv galair.
And now we have three very special musical pieces lined up for you. First, we will hear an Irish song, an Irish language song, Cúin, featuring musicians and singers from Ireland and Malawi in the new Irish Chichewa version of this beautiful piece, recorded especially for the embassy for St. Patrick's Day. And I'd like to thank my niece Carmel for all her help with this. Next is a lovely piece from harpist Shauna Davey, recorded at St. Patrick's Hall for Tradfest 2021. And finally, we will have Irish singer-songwriter Shiv, and she has produced a special recording of her song, You and I, from her debut EP, Me to Me, for our reception tonight. And I think I should mention that Shiv is daughter of our head of development, Dermot, that many of you will know. So I hope you enjoyed the performance. Buen saltos.
Wow, Taukulangi lai, Dia yu yiv, Royela porik, Sona du yiv kolai. Have a St. Patrick's Day from our shared communities in Ireland and Malawi. From the pacific shores of Lake Malawi, to the tranquil coast of Ireland. We invite you to celebrate this day with us by taking a moment to be keen, jade, calm.
Agus fiáúsir leag na chlí. Siúl taobhlam ag fiáúsú na chrí. Ná bhaag mú.
Mola ni bwala mwe wanga. Mola ni nyonga zirowe mafubanga. Mola ni jembegezo mdzigo. Molani udiba kale kumbo na mkulu gilana kubanda manyazi. Molani udimisozi ndijisangalalo zigule ndikujilitsa. Molani andu wakondane padziko. Molani udiba kale kuwala ndipo wapanda chisoni. Molani sangalalo chimwemwe ndikukoma. Mzimu wa jimlengalenga ubweletse majilito kwa onse odwala.
Thank you. Though the instrument is found across different nations and cultures worldwide, the harp is forever associated with Ireland as our ancient national emblem. Here, rising star Seana Davy performs on the traditional Irish harp from St. Patrick's Hall in Dublin Castle.
I swear it's a word. I guess I was hoping you would wanna stay. Kinda hoping you'd wanna grow. Don't wanna be left out here on my own. I found a place that I could call home.
Thanks everybody for joining us this evening, and I hope you enjoy this wonderful feast of music and song that I think reflects very well on both of our cultures. I want to say thanks to everyone who was involved in putting this program together, both here and in Ireland. Perhaps it's something we will do in the future, even when we return to being able to host our normal receptions. Thanks everybody again for tuning in and joining in with us. And I hope you enjoy the rest of St. Patrick's Day, no matter where you are in the world. Go Míle Maith Agaibh, Go Léir, agus Slán Tamall.